Hello and welcome to my channel. Today is going to be the first of a three-part series on mold. Make sure you hit the subscribe and notification bell so you don't miss the rest of the series when it comes out. So let's say you suspect mold in your home. What should you do about it? Testing can be really, really expensive and can often be done wrong. In this video, I'm going to try to help you save some money and make sure it's done right as well. But first, we need to talk a little bit more about mold. There are a lot of different kinds of mold, but we can put them into two broad categories, indoor mold and outdoor mold. Outdoor molds co-evolved with humans and were generally able to tolerate them fairly well. Sometimes they travel into your home on shoes or on pets or through open windows, but again, they don't generally pose much of a problem for us. The indoor molds, however, are newer, evolutionarily speaking. This is the type of mold that grows on drywall and insulation and other building materials. And these are the ones that can cause some really big problems with your health. And within that category of problematic indoor molds, there are many different strains. Some are lighter and they can float around in the air, but others, like Stachybotrys, for example, are very heavy, sticky spores. They tend to drop really quickly and stay on the ground. Now, this is why air sampling in particular can be very problematic. I've heard from so many people that they had an inspector come out, the inspector did air sampling and found nothing and told them that their house was fine, but they were really, really sick and they knew something was going on. That's because air sampling is typically set up a couple feet off the ground. That's only going to capture the air that's coming in higher up. So if you have a sticky, heavy spore like Stachybotrys that's on the ground, it's not going to capture it. Now, this doesn't mean that air sampling is completely useless. When it's done right, it can be a piece of the puzzle. Now, what do I mean when I say done right? This is key. The inspector should agitate the area he is attempting to take an air sample from. So if you're in a room with a carpet or a couch or any kind of material that could potentially be holding onto those spores, you want the inspector to take a stick or a broom or something and vigorously beat that area to agitate the spores and allow them to come up into the air so that that air sampling that's set up higher up can actually capture it. So again, this can be a piece of the puzzle, but in my opinion, the best way to get started is by using an ERMI. ERMI stands for Environmental Relative Moldiness Index. This was developed by the EPA as a measure for how moldy one house is compared to another home. Now, if your home shows up much moldier on an ERMI compared to other homes, then you know you have a problem. But most importantly, the ERMI is like a Swiffer cloth. So you can take that and go wherever you need to try to capture spores wherever you think they might be. So this is key again for those big, heavy, sticky spores, because you can take your ERMI cloth and sample a baseboard, or if you think it's coming from the roof, you can sample way up high on a bookshelf, again, where the air sample probably wouldn't reach it. So with the ERMI, you have the ability to go anywhere you need to in your home and collect a variety of samples to fill up that cloth. That then gets mailed in to the company and they look at it underneath the microscope using DNA, PCR technology to tell you exactly what types of molds are present. That's another benefit of the ERMI. They're not just going to tell you you have mold, they're going to tell you what type. Is it the indoor type? Is it the outdoor type? Is it Stachybotrys, Chadasporium, Wollemia sebi? There's all these different types of mold and the ERMI will tell you exactly what kind you're dealing with. Again, make sure you hit the subscribe and notification bell, because in video number two, I'm going to tell you why knowing this specific type of mold is important for your treatment. Now, another benefit of the ERMI is that they generally run around $300. Hiring an inspector to come into your home can cost anywhere between $500 and $5,000, depending on how many air samples they need to take, how long they're in your home, how many tape samples they might take, and more. So what I typically tell my clients to do is start with an ERMI. If you don't find any mold and you've sampled everywhere you can think of in your house, then you might not even need that inspector in the first place. But if you do find mold, now you have proof. You know there's mold in your house. And then when you bring an inspector out, you already know exactly what you're looking for and they can help you determine where it's coming from. Again, I've seen inspectors come out to people's houses and say, well, there's no mold here, you're fine. And they wasted all that money, they didn't find anything and they leave. But if you have an inspector come out and you show him your ERMI and you show him you know there is mold, you just need him to find it, he can be a lot more targeted in his approach. Now, when you do get an inspector, try to see if you can find one that has some extra gear that they're gonna come come with beyond just the air sample. If they have thermal imaging cameras, they can look for cold spots. Cold spots indicate water. So if you can't find the source of your mold and he's looking around with this thermal image camera and he happens to see a cold spot in the wall, then you can investigate that specific wall for maybe a small pipe leak that occurred inside the wall that's not visible to the naked eye. This is actually what happened to us in one of the apartments that we lived in. I got really, really sick. I knew there was mold, but we couldn't see it and we couldn't find it. So someone came out with thermal imaging. They saw a cold spot in our wall. They put a little hole in the wall and lo and behold, there was a tiny little dripping leak that had been going on for who knows how long. The entire wall cavity was filled with black mold. Now, if we had just done air sampling, we may or may not have ever captured that. But because we used thermal imaging and I also ran an ERMI, we were able to determine not only that there was mold, we knew what type and we knew where it was located so that we could act quickly. Now, in the next video in this series, I'm going to tell you what to do if you think you've become sick from mold. I'm going to tell you how to test for it in your body and how to begin going through treatment as well. But I hope today's video was helpful and hopefully I saved you a few $1,000 by starting with an ERMI instead of starting with an inspector. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comment box below and I'll see you in the next video.